gonna blow your face out.
That's our in-studio guest this week. Another lifetime ago. For about a dozen years, Peter Wolf was the fast-talking front man for the Jay Giles Band, which started as the best bar band in New England, but quickly became the 70s hardest-driving blues rock outfit, known for legendary live shows and a string of hits, including Musta Got Lost, Centerfold, Southside Shuffle, Love Stinks, just to name a few. But Peter was actually a visual artist long before he ever thought of fronting a rock band. He was also a DJ in Boston in the late 60s, which gave him the opportunity to interview and hang with the likes of Van Morrison, Muddy Waters, Howlin' Wolf, and many more future legends. After the Jay Giles Band split up in the early 80s, Peter launched his solo career, steadily moving away from the Giles sound and into a blues-based Americana sound, which has now come to his seventh studio disc called Midnight Souvenirs. One might call Midnight Souvenirs a country record, but it's really just the next step from his last album, 2002's Sleepless, which Rolling Stone magazine named one of the 500 greatest albums ever made. Peter worked with producer Kenny White, who's done his last three records. His guests include Shelby Lynn, Nico Case, and the great country legend Merle Haggard. And he co-wrote most of the songs with his longtime friend and hit songwriter Will Jennings. And that is where we're going to start our conversation this week with Peter Wolf, joining us in an extended visit as our in-studio guest on Acoustic Cafe.
You know, I think first thing I want to talk about are some of the partnerships that made this album possible. Starting with Will Jennings, this is a partnership for you and a friendship that goes back 20 years, right?
Yeah, I really enjoy collaboration. I came out of a band, and one thing about a band, when it's really a band, is there's collaboration going on. When I found myself becoming a solo artist, not by choice, when, shall we say, the great cliche of artistic differences set in. And I was looking for different people to write with. Will was someone that always interested me. I knew Stevie Winwood, and I knew the work he did with Stevie Winwood, and I knew the work he did with B.B. King. And so I called a gentleman by the name of Lance Freed, who's the son of Alan Freed, who's Will's publisher. And he put us together, and one day he was in a hotel room, and he had several bottles of beer. Well, not beer, it's actually wine sitting in a cooler, and I could tell one bottle was already empty. And he told me Chet Baker died. And so I joined him in celebrating the life of Chet Baker, and we ended up out in the street and going to several bar rooms. And from that point, we became very good friends. When we get together, we catch up, and it's we sit on his veranda and open up a nice glass of wine and just chat about life. And that's really how they enter the songs.
It has to be. There has to be a social component to this.
Yeah, right? This is not. This is not the kind of songwriting.
It's not appointment writing.
No, it's not. This is not like, hey, I got a great hook.
Long time since we've been together. You know life don't last forever. I wanna love you one more time. I hang around all over town. See if you're up, see if you're down. What can I do? I'm always asking for you. I walk the streets.
Asking for You, the original on the new album Midnight Souvenirs. Our in-studio guest this week, Peter Wolf.
Now, the other partnership involved in this record would be the producer, the co-producer, Kenny White, who's produced the last three records with you, and is also a singer and a songwriter, a song crafter in his own right. Is it helpful to have another artist in the producer's chair rather than just a producer?
Well, to be honest, I don't consider myself a musician. I'm a fan. When I make a record or perform it vicariously, I get to play with the players I play with, and to be able to record duets with people like Mick Jagger or Aretha Franklin, or in his last album, Nico Case, and Shelby Lynn, and of course Merle. It's just a thrill for me. But someone even like Kenny, who I believe has the gift, when you put it together, not unlike a film or a play, a great collaboration, the better the collaborators, the better the end results are. And the thrill for me is that I get to watch these guys or ladies do what they do.
You mentioned the duets. Each person perfectly picked for their part. Shelby Lynn, new friend? Have you known her a while?
It's so funny. I wrote the song Tragedy with a friend of mine, Angelo. As soon as we finished the song, I said, man, I don't know why, but I think this would be perfect for Shelby Lynn. I said, Angelo, do you know Shelby? He said, well, no, I really don't. And, met her a couple of times, but I can't say I know her. And I called a friend that day who, strangely enough, was meeting Shelby in about an hour. So I said, could you ask Shelby if she'd be interested in maybe doing a song if I sent it to her and she liked it? And she said, sure. She called me back and said, Shelby, I'd love to hear the song. And I sent it to her. And she called me about 2 days later and was very excited and said, you know, Shelby really loves the song. She wants to do it.
I think I won the Fool's Award today. The way I made my baby cry. I can't believe the stupid things I say without a one good reason why.
And, you know, the best way of doing something like that is doing it together, obviously. It didn't quite work out, so I did the thing which I really don't like to do, is send out the track and have her sing on it. She sent back the track, and I got a telephone call. It's Peter, Shelby. I go, hey, Shelby. He goes, you loving it? I said, Shelby, it's good. She said, honey, are you loving it?
The game of love becomes a
said, I don't want to be on your record. I said, what? She said, no, man, you got to love this thing. I got to love this thing. I said, man, this sending this tape stuff, man, it ain't going to work.
What have you ever took your love from me? Now that would be the tragedy.
We got to cut this song live. Bring a bottle of bourbon. I'll get a bottle of bourbon. We'll have to drink about half of it down. We'll go into the studio and just cut this thing hot and sweaty. And that's what we did.
This could be called Lover's Requiem, but it's entitled Then It Leaves Us All Behind.
Can't stay.
On the new one, Midnight Souvenirs, Peter Wolf is our in-studio guest this week.
And then there's It's Too Late for Me.
Mm.
It's an original song. And Merle Haggard, the absolute perfect choice, the only choice. Did you write the song with that in mind?
No, it was Will, really, that we were sitting in his little hut. And it was one of those moments for both of us where the sentiment of the song being, is it too late for us, too late for me? And I actually went down to Nashville to meet three of the writers that I really respected throughout the years. One was Hank Cochran, and it turned out he was out fishing. The other was Don Gibson, and actually the day I got to Nashville, he was rushed to the hospital, unfortunately, got very ill. And the third was Harlan Howard, who I did get to meet, and that's an adventure in itself. And there's a gentleman down there by the name of Frank Mull, who's very close with Merle Haggard. And I had known Frank many years while we were on Capitol Records, and that was the label that Merle was on. And I said to Frank, listen, I have this song, and I wondered if you would do me the great pleasure or honor of just sending it to Merle and just seeing if he takes to it. And Merle heard the song and said, man, I love it. Where did this Lefty Frizzell song come from? And that was like the greatest compliment ever. Lefty, people don't know, he was one of the great pioneers of classic country. And he, along with Hank Williams, probably were the two pillars that most of the honky-tonk music was built on. And sitting in a room with Merle Haggard, being about a foot away, watching him close his eyes and hear him interpret it, you walk away from it knowing that you've witnessed something that is so transcending. There'll be nobody to fill those shoes.
The lovers two by two along the avenue are such a beautiful sight to see. But as they pass me by, it makes me wanna cry. I know it's too late for me. It seems so long ago when someone loved me so. We were both so young and so free. And
though I still can see how good life used to be. I know it's too late for me. The days go by, the days go by. There's a heartache I can't eat. The nights come on and I'm all alone with just my precious memory. Now to me it seems I've always lived in dreams of how I wanted my life to be. I wake to morning cool, there's nothing left to hold. I know it's too late for me. I wake to morning cool, there's nothing left to hold. It's too late for me.
On the album version of that, on Midnight Souvenirs, that is done as a duet with the great Merle Haggard. It is our in-studio guest this week, Peter Wolf, and the song It's Too Late for Me. And we're going to have more in an extended visit with Peter Wolf this week on Acoustic Cafe. And Peter is joined by a fantastic band, including Marty Ballou on bass, John Carroll playing the piano. Duke Levine is on various guitars, Kevin Berry playing the steel guitar, and Marty Richards is playing the drums. And more from all of them in the second hour on Acoustic Cafe. Anytime you want to hear one of our guests and their in-studio performances, archives are at mlive.com/cafe. Again, the archive site, mlive.com/cafe. And you can get there through our regular site, thanks to Segnet Technologies of New Hampshire. You're listening to Acoustic Cafe. I'm Rob Reinhart. It's time now for more in our extended visit with our guest this week, Peter Wolf. The new album is called Midnight Souvenirs. And Peter and the band did this version of a song that's on that disc called Lying Low.
Life is so mysterious, I get a bit delirious. Earth beneath my feet start moving so. I said hurricanes and lightning, Lord, I get so frightened. When the big wind comes, you gotta let it blow. And I'm lying low, looking for another way to go. And I'm lying low, everything's a gamble. Baby, I was good for you. Chopped a lot of wood for you. Let us not forget the times we had. But I believe in moving on. Just before the love is gone, you gotta take the good times with the bad. I'm lying low, looking for another way.
day. Out along that long highway, there's always something happening ahead. Well, pardon me for this goodbye. I'll let you know the reason why. There's a lot of world to see and then you're dead. Ha! I'm lying low.
And his fantastic band, live in our studios, with a song from the Midnight Souvenirs album called Lying Low. Our in-studio guest this week, Peter Wolf.
I should also point out that when people see this record, there are a couple of drawings on here, a couple of photographs as well. This is another pursuit that I believe predates music for you, as you mentioned. I mean, drawing right. has always been there. Do you go back and forth between the two? Does one provide refuge from the other? And if you're having trouble at one, and also is drawing the ongoing pursuit? You may not always be working on a song, but you're always working on a drawing or a painting.
Well, they're very similar, because when you start with a song, you might have an idea, you might have a mood. There might be a title, say like Lonely Afternoon. And it might just start from there. Or you might hear a phrase, someone at a bar, like Harlan Howard used to always say, I love going to bars. I love to hear pickup cliches. Well, he also loved to drink, too. But with a drawing, it's the same thing. You might have an idea like, well, you know, that face or that vase or that lovely lady, I'm going to try capturing that. And you never really know if you're going to succeed. How complicated it's going to be. Is it going to be easy? It's going to be hard. If it's going to take an hour, if it's going to take 3 weeks. That is what I find very similar about the two of them. With the painting aspect, the music business or industry sometimes can become, and it's changing all the time, and it's dismantling, and there's so much upheaval that the idea of sometimes just want to get out there and play becomes so complicated. It's real nice to be able to just take a brush, stick it in a nice little bottle of India ink, and just go.
There's a solo career.
There's a solo career. But again, what brought me to music and what excited me about music was the aspect of being in a collaborative situation and being in a band where together you worked on the song and you woodshedded on the song, and if you worked on the harmonies, and if you didn't get it, you know, you had a team, and it was nice. And also if you performed, it was an immediate response, where within drawing, it is far more solitary, and sometimes you can be your own worst enemy and throw something away that maybe was worth keeping. But they're similar.
Everything's gone all wrong. I need another beer.
And so they did.
A song written by Seth Justman and our in-studio guest this week, Peter Wolf, which was first released by Graham Parsons on a 1973 album called GP. And it did eventually also surface on a Jay Giles Band anthology as well. Cry One More Time from our in-studio guest this week, Peter Wolf.
Last question I have for you. After four plus decades on the road, there can't be a lot of surprises on the road, but there has to be joy. You keep doing it. What part of that is still enjoyable for you?
Well, that's a very good question. Being able to feel that one can still create something that has a certain validity, and to be able to sit in a room surrounded by musicians, as I did earlier today, and hear their contribution, that's what's worthwhile. Because after all the songs and after all the parties and after the chairs are on top of the table and after the lights go out, really the party's over. But it's really just the work that remains. And so when I think of people like Raymond Chandler, who I love, or I think of Chaim Soutine, a painter I adore, it's their work that remains. And when I think of Ray Charles or Muddy and Howlin' Wolf, it's the work. It's their work that they left behind that endures. And I guess that's the famous line of William Faulkner, where he said, it's the man is the creative parts that will endure, the spirit that endures. And all I try to do, ever since I was young, I've seen so many different artists. I grew up, my dad was tried to be an artist, but the difficulties, the odds were too great for him. And I don't think he was able to fight it. And fortunately, I have been very lucky into being sometimes at the right time in the right place and working with people who've really helped me be able to fulfill the dreams I want to do. All right. To the south side of Chicago. Yeah. Oh, take me with you, baby. Time about going to school. The way you love me so. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework anymore. Oh, baby, you got me so blind. You got me running around in circles, about to lose my mind. The way you love me so. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework anymore. Now, baby, you're sweet as you can be. Everything you do is like a sin to me. Kiss your lips, the touch of your hand. Whatever you're doing, child, is really grand. Oh, baby, what can I do? You got a whoop, a group of mama chupa running around in circles of love with you. When you love me so. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework. Grand. Oh, baby, what can I say? You got me running around all circles, honey, every which way. Boy, I love you. I love you so. I can't do my homework anymore. I can't do my homework anymore. Yeah.
Rush song, which was done 40 years ago by the Jay Giles Band and done again in a version very similar to that back in 2002 by Peter Wolf on an album called Sleepless and done live in our studios. Peter Wolf and a fantastic band. Peter's new album is called Midnight Souvenirs, and he was joined in this week's appearance by Marty Ballou playing the bass, John Carroll on piano, Duke Levine playing guitars, Kevin Berry on acoustic and steel guitar, and Marty Richards playing the drums. Again, Peter Wolf and the new album, Midnight Souvenirs, which you'll find on the Verve record label.